हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम यू ऑल वंस अगेन इन लेक्चर सीरीज मैन्युफैक्चरिंग टेक्नोलॉजी। आई अमित तिवारी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, सुरेश ज्ञान विहार यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे इज सिक्स्थ लेक्चर एंड टॉपिक इज सेंट्रीफ्यूगल कास्टिंग एंड स्ट्रैक कास्टिंग। सो लेट स्टार्ट। द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ टुडे लेक्चर इज टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रोसेस ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल एंड स्ट्रैक कास्टिंग टेक्निक। सो बेसिकली वी अंडरस्टैंड टुडे द व्हाट आर द प्रोसेस ऑफ गोइंग थ्रू द in centrifugal casting and how we can fabricate the composite material with the help of the stack casting technique. And to understand the fabrication of also the composite material, because the composite material is very recently very popular nowadays, and every industry want to make a composite material. So what type of composite material we fabricated on stack casting process discussing in this today talk lecture. The outcome is to understand the various material used for the casting principle and their application. So you, after that lecture, end of the lecture, you will be able to understand the various material used for the casting and various material used for the stack casting technique to fabricate the composite material. So these are the today discussion on the basis of fabrication of composite material and the casting we will discussing now in this lecture today. So the first introduction, basically what is centrifugal casting? The centrifugal casting is basically, you understand that with the help of a centrifugal force, we providing some centrifugal force on the permanent mould which are placed on the rotating during the solidification of casting. Because when the mould is allowed to liquidify and it convert into a solidify completely after certain time or temperature at a below temperature and convert to the high temperature of liquidify, which is required to the hot rolling process or cold rolling process to providing or to enhance the we can say that the hardness of the particular material. So in the centrifugal casting, the difference basically is that the same particles or the same number of forces are applied, but with the help of the centrifugal force. With the help of centrifugal force, we require that the die we are producing for the desired pattern, and those pattern are applied the forces by the centrifugal act on that particular area. With that is all are the liquid material will spread over the MPT area where to conduct the solidification, and after the converting the solidification, it is required to spread out all the casting material, and you can find out the solidification converting the form of the product. So basically the working phenomena of this in this type of casting is that I'm just mentioning here, no core is used in the process. So what is the no core is in this process? Because for developing a solid casting, the rotation of axis is shifted at the end of the casting. Basically the shifted of the casting alloy, which we are fabricated of any material, whatever you design, you want to fabricate as a complex design or simple design. All those type of design are fabricated, but with the help of the centrifugal casting, the rotating of the hull desk, which are centered by the revolving wheel, and these wheels are isolated in the center part of the pattern where you can put all the liquid material and allow to solidify with some centrifugal force acting on the corrosion of the body. Fit that, you will be find that the final output product with the form of solidify. So they are the basically the three types of centrifugal castings basically are generally now in popular. First is a true centrifugal casting, second is a semi-centrifugal casting, and the third one is centrifugal or pressure casting. These three type of casting are now generally popular, and it is very good process, and nowadays most of the industries are used this type of casting because they are widely advantages. So let's discuss one by one. There's a first is a true centrifugal casting. So these are some diagram we can see in the centrifugal casting is here, where you can find that these are bottom the two rollers. Yeah, the two rollers are continuously rolling on the there's a force, centrifugal force are generated on the bottom face of the this roller. You can see this is a molten metal entry petal will fill in the base area. This is a molten coating which is converted currently by the centrifugal force fill up, and all the material are spread together. With the help of this, we can manage all and each and every columns is fill the material properly with the help of the centrifugal force, because that this two roller are bottom side are stable, and the two same direction at the top of the two roller are also situation for continuously maintain the forces or to revolving the this movable coating. So with the help of this motor, you will create a centrifugal force, and all this molten metal are drawn into the this coating and allowed to solidify, and after that you will be removed the upper portion, and you can find out the centrifugal casting with the help of this. You can now fabricate a prepared product. So basically what happened, the true centrifugal casting, in the true centrifugal casting, the hollow cylinder part such as a pipe, gun barrel, and we can say the lamp lost are produced by the technique which is shown in the figure. Okay, so in which the molten metal is poured into the rotating ball, the axis of rotating is usually horizontal, but we can set a vertical for a workpiece of molten are made up of steel or iron and graphite, and that are made to be coating with the refractory lines to increasing the molting life, which is not required for any other type of casting. It is only suitable for the true centrifugal casting. Therefore, we can select this type of special cases on the centrifugal casting. So, molting surface can be shaped so that the pipe width varies, outer shape and inner shape, including the shape square and polygonal, which we can also cast with the help of the true centrifugal casting. And we can say the inner portion of the center casting. We will be produced by the help of the applying the centrifugal force. I'm just mentioning the centrifugal force because centrifugal force is the responsible to provide the proper shaping or to fill up the gap between the filler materials, that we can provide the proper handling of the molten metal in the surface of the workpiece. So whenever you have made the material, you just be aware that whenever the centrifugal force is applied on the casting, during casting, you must be reminded the one thing, that is the force is appropriated, but if the too much amount of forces you are applied, that is dangerous for the our machining, because at the time the vibration are occurring, due to the vibration the crack are formation on the surface of the solidification, which is the loss of our workpiece. So for reminder that too much not force required, we require some standard or require as per the requirement of force we applied for the machining to produce the centrifugal casting. Now another is Department of Mechanical Engineering, that means true centrifugal casting process. True centrifugal casting process, that means you can see in this diagram there are two rollers, that is the driving shaft are providing in the bottom base of the this basement, the driven shaft. And the rollers are putting on the other two rollers, and these are the rotating mold. This mold is currently rotating with a certain speed, and these are the pouring brush basin where the molten metal from the lead from the metal and just allowed to liquefy at the rotating mold, and rotating mold is continually rotating with the centrifugal force by the help of the motor. With the help of the motor, this centrifugal casting will be completed, and it gives some important shape that we can say to make the cylinder or you make the some pipe. So with the help of this type of casting, you will be fabricated the cylinder and the pipe section type of product. So it is very important now, type of very, very good and fast production technique we increasing with the help of the centrifugal casting. Centrifugal casting, why it is called, again I'm just telling you, because due to the force that is a centrifugal force acting on the roller, that is a rotating mold, and the roller are continuously moved with the help of centrifugal force by the help of the motor, electric motor, and there's some certain amount of liquid molten metal are placed on the surface of roller, and it when it will be round with a certain RPM, it will convert the whole liquid hollow cylinder to convert into soil cylinder, and this cylinder will help to fabricate and which the porous that means material, if you found it is the surface is not the irregular, then you will be what we do, we will to again remelt the material and convert into the that is structure again with the help of this true centrifugal casting. Now second one is the semi-centrifugal casting. What is the difference between the semi-centrifugal casting and converting? I just discussed now. It is also known as the profited and centrifugal casting. That is the profited centrifugal casting. It is nearly similar to the true centrifugal casting. and with the only difference that is the center core is used to form the inner surface. It is the most important you understand that is the center core is used to form the inner surface, the center core. The center force or core of the calcite in the diagram, I am just showing you this later, I am discussing after completing this slide. However, the centrifugal force aid in the proper feeding of mold cavity. In the process, the axis of the spin is always vertical. Okay, it's demanded that the spin is always vertical. And this method is used for the cast part with the rotating cylindrical such as the wheel, the spoke and rotatory speed for the form of the casting are not great as the true of centrifugal casting. This process is used only for the symmetrical object and yield distance of the centrifugal casting. With the help of if you want to fly, make a flywheel, if you want to gear, if you want to track wheel. So these all other parts are fabricated by the help of the centrifugal casting. So these are the applications of centrifugal casting. What type of material you product you will be fabricated by the help of centrifugal casting? The gear, different type of gear, different type of flywheel, different type of track wheels. These all are the product and many more products similar like this we will be fabricated on the semi-centrifugal casting. Now diagram explain here, we can see in this diagram that is the description of a semi-centrifugal casting, that is this, you can see the direction of the rotation, you can see this is kind of rotation are here and it is continuously this body is moving around in certain speed. And where you can see here, these are the some sand are fill up inside the metal, this are inside the material, and these are the some pattern, these are the pattern, this you can see, this is a pattern, you can see this is a pattern and I section pattern. We can say that this is a wheel, obviously this is the fabrication of the wheel. If you want to make a track wheel or any wheel, let you make a fly wheel, that this type of centrifugal casting you can be fabricated by this. So these are the practical example of making the centrifugal let can say the track wheel. So what happened in this, you can see here, these are the some sands are provided on the surrounding inside the pattern. These are the pattern, these are the first of all in this case, this is the MPT pattern. Okay, this is MPT. After the metal will be just convert into liquid in the furnace, it will transfer to the this MPT area and fill up with the this surrounding, you can say this sand are here, who can prevent the holding the metal and convert allow to solid liquid to solidify, and this rotation of the direction of rotation of wheel continuously moving to surrounding together with a certain speed. At the time what happened, the all the metal are mixed together and there is no any space or filler or gaping or missing, all the gap are filled with the help of centrifugal casting, semi-centrifugal casting. And what happened with this, you can fabricate the wheel. You can fabricate the wheel by semi-centrifugal casting, and it is the most common and popular process are known as this nowadays, because it is easiest to form and faster production we can show the innovative production industry. And the number of products we will be fabricated with the help of this type of casting. So these are the flank. That is provided in the surface layer. We can extend the now dividing the two parts. That is the lower portion we can say drag and the upper portion we can cop. And after the converting to 35, you can remove the cop portion because this is a temporary, this is a movable, and the drag portion is perfect with the rotating ball. So after that you will be remove the type of material. Upper part of the metal pop and you can find out that this metal will be allowed to solidify, and it is also known as the centrifugal casting is the final product of the as a wheel fabrication. So these are some examples of semi-centrifugal casting. So this type of metal, if you want to fabricate, so you will be allowed to the centrifugal casting with the help of the centrifugal force, you will be fabricate this type of portion. Another one is semi-centrifugal casting, or we can say the pressure casting, basically when we can say the pressure casting, centrifugal casting, both are same. What happened in this type of casting, the several casting cavities are located around the outer portion of the mold, and the melt is fitted to this cavity by radiant grids from the center. Either single or a stack can be used. This mouth cavity are filled under the pressure of the centrifugal force of the metal as the mouth is rotating. Both are same. You can see this diagram, and you can see this diagram. The both features are same, but different difference between that, and you can change the structure of the semi-centrifugal to we can say the centrifugal casting, which is pressure casting. So you can apply the some pressure on the bottom on the base layer of the body. But apply this body, you can melt the temperature maintaining on the surface of we can say the casting. What happened in this diagram? That basically this for understanding the difference between the semi-centrifugal, centrifugal, and the pressure casting is to that the differencing on the structure and the forcing applying on the body. This method of casting and not limited to centrifugal object can be produced a casting or irregular form shape such as the preparing caps or a small brackets. These dental professions use the process of casting bold inlay. If we can say the vertical direction can be possible. So I'm just showing in a diagram. You can see this diagram. So what happens is the components, pressure casting first in a molten metal. You can see this is a molten metal inside this. You can see here these are the hashing portion. Each cell, so you can see each cell is represented by the container for the molten metal. These are the container for the molten metal. And you can see this pipe is basically valve is basically closed for because if the unwanted air is passed and it will spread all the liquid material will be destroyed the workpiece. And this is the blank portion. This is, you can say this portion is airtight seal chamber. The air is based on no transformation of air to inside or outside to the surrounding or the body. You can say refractory tube. These are the refractory tubes which is provided for the we can say to providing to the liquid eludify in the proper manner and it will be fixed on a particular this middle section where to just allow to solidify product. Can move upon or draw to remove open or close the molden. This is used to upon down of the close the molden. If you want to apply the low pressure, then you can down. If you apply the high pressure, you can down towards and we remove the pressure and remove the force and we will take up for direction. And this by this we can manage the different type of forces that is required as per the condition, as per the requirement, as per the applications of that. So the next is a mold. This is a mold. You can see these are the mold. We can fill up the mold and transfer to this molten metal area. This is filled up by the mold. Casting cavity, these are the boxes converted by casting cavity. Some cavity are presented, it will be removed from the surface of the casting cavity zone. So you can understand that during the pressure casting, it is most important to understand the temperature of liquidify is allowed to solidify take some time because it depending on the pressure, depending on the structure or size of the shape of the casting, you must be aware that when you allow to decreasing the temperature, when you allow to increase in the pressure, you must be that the pressure will be uniformly distributed or it will transfer to the same direction with equal and same time because of what happens certain area are a slope of formation surface of the body, then it will be damaged or it will not require for the our operation. So it must be aware that for during the manufacturing of in a centrifugal casting. So I hope you understand the basic structure of the semi-centrifugal casting, centrifugal casting, and pressure casting. So these are the difference between the all three. And generally, the what happens is in which the pressure casting is the most popular as compared to the three type of casting: rigid true casting, semi-centrifugal casting, and pressure casting. Also, and the centrifugal casting. So in which the pressure casting is the most popular due to the several advantages, due to the more features are available in the casting body. You can see also in the diagram it will show that if you selected this type of casting, it is a bit rapidly application based because it is used for the wheel making, used for the flywheel making. It will be used for the certain different type of compound that is larger or smaller in size, so you will fabricate on the pressure casting, but it is not possible for the centrifugal casting. If you want to fabricate the wheel and if you want to fabricate the flywheel, it is happening on it. It is not happening on the this type of pressure casting. So with the help of the pressure casting, you will be fabricate the some we can say the small brackets and bearings and golden inlay. So these all are the products you fabricate in this type of casting, and remaining product will just a cylindrical or becomes a flywheel fabricated on the semi-centrifugal casting. I hope you understand the process of casting, true casting, semi-centrifugal casting, and true pressure casting. So these all are the advantages and the application, what type of application will require to fabricate, you will be selection of this type of casting for that particular operation. Now there are some advantages of centrifugal casting are as follows, because we know that every material have advantages, every machine have advantages and disadvantages. So obviously there's some advantages in centrifugal casting. The first is quick and economical than other method. That is quick, that is fast production. And economically, it is easy to fabricate this product in the centrifugal casting rather than the other type of casting. Because what one basically, with the help of centrifugal casting, you do not require too much amount of force. Initially, you will provide a force, but after that, this force will continue to generate it as the application or as the requirement will increase or decrease. It is very quick and easily used for fast production. Second is, in this process, the user of riser, feed head, and cords, etc., is eliminated. You must be reminded that in this process, this use of riser, feed header, and cords is eliminated. Because this in this process, the use of this type of structure, this type of components are eliminated with the help of centrifugal casting. Third one is, we can say the ferrous as well as the non-ferrous metal can be casted. It not be special type of casting we require for purpose material. We require the ferrous metal as well as the non-ferrous metal also. So there is not a special type of material we use for that particular casting. It is the common advantages, because every material is used for the semi-centrifugal or centrifugal casting. They do not require a special type of material. Fourth one is that the casting produce have a defense and a fine gradient structure with all the impurity focused on force based back to the center where they can be frequently machined out. So basically we can say that the casting produce have a denser and fine grained structure. Denser and the fine grained structure will be produced for the impurity of the force back. With the help of this, you will be reduce the impurity. We can improve the surface quality. We can improve the production cost. We can improve the, we can say the smoothness, or we can reduce the surface of face by this type of casting. And fifth is good surface finishing. Ultimately, the sole objective of the subject is to maintain the finishing, or we maintain the good smoothness, or to reduce the minimum investment of cost. That is the most important objective of our for this course. And obviously, the centrifugal casting is one of them to allow the good surface finishing with the minimum investment of cost and a low power consumption with that. Sixth one is the gate and rise can be kept to minimum. That means that the gate is basically, we can say, the minimum criteria if you selected, or a minimum number of rays or minimum forces you required, it will easy to understand to handle, or it will easy to understand the keep to the parameters. Because the parameter if you increasing, for example, if you increasing the number of gate or improving the number of forces, it will be dangerous for reducing the properties of the material as well as the cushion vibration and to increasing the generated. So it will reduce the surface quality, I think. Okay, the disadvantages are, there are some also disadvantages in casting, centrifugal casting. First is metallic composition of alloy is not uniformly to the casting. The most important, it is metallic composition of alloy is not uniform throughout the casting, because this type of metallic composition are not alloy. These are the limitations of this casting, and you can use ferrous metal and non-ferrous metal, but you do not require any the metallic composition of alloy in the uniform throughout the casting. Secondly, casting must be symmetrically. It will be flexible and rigid in shape. Next is limited to the small interacting casting. That means the there are some limitations because you cannot apply too much amount of force. You cannot provide a different type of shape. If there's some special type of shape required, you will for making the casting. We require the if you want to make the flywheel and the circular cylindrical bar, it will be possible. If you make the some piston design or like cylindrical design of a head, it is not possible on the shape type of casting because not available features are there. So you kept in mind regarding to some limitations are for imitation casting. And the line indicates that the mechanical property of centrifugal casting are superior to those of sand casting, but gravity segregation in incorporated in a sub-alloy. Yes, obviously the mechanical property of centrifugal casting are superior, and we don't know, we have no doubt. But due to the sand casting, it will achieve. So also we provide a sand casting. You see, you can see here, these are the provided by sand casting in this diagram. And are provided inside the pattern. We can see inside the structure zone of the material. But the sand casting, you will provide the complete structure and basic formation of wheel. So which is not allowed to this type of diagram. We can say provide any material with another casting. With the only is possible for centrifugal casting. So the continuous casting, or we can say the strain casting, that is a produce a higher steel, higher quality steel for a less cost. It is the most advantageous feature of this continuous casting because it produces a higher quality of steel with the minimum investment of cost, because we require the less money and more quality of product. It will be achieved by the continuous casting. Second one is the, how is the procedure follow? First is the point is the molten metal is ladled in plane and equalized in the temperature by the blowing nitrogen gas through it for 5 to 10 minutes. You can see here in this diagram. It's a diagram of continuous casting, where in which the molten metal in the ladle is clean and equally in temperature by the blowing nitrogen gases through the 5 to 10 minutes. After the second step is the metal is then poured into a refractory line and intermittently poured vessel at the tungsten, where the impurities are scaled off and the tungsten hold as much as the three zone of the metal, and we can improve the travel during the water flow and allow to solidify in the upward downward position after by the roller. You can see here in this diagram what happened. Basically, these are the tunnels. We can store all the molten metal, and you allow to just drop down into the this structure. You can see these are the complete structure of solidify structure, and these are the roller. It can provide the some proper shape. You can see the initial starting shape of very width is very high, but when you goes downward and the rolling process are held on for reducing the diameter and for applying some certain force on the surface of the work of material, it will reduce diameter and proper the give propine the shape of the standard shape will be provide for particular operation. So the diameter will be reduced with the help of the roller and oxygen lens for cutting the cutting. If you want to cutting this particular section, this oxygen lens is used for that purpose. So these all are the basically application of casting. Thus, continuous casting basically the product high quality steel. So it is also used for the fabrication of the high quality steel. With the help of this diagram, we will show the other process structure. These are the process structure of that, which is required in our for increase the quality of the steel. Basically, what happened? Basically, generally. You can see here the diagram. These are the ladle which we have collected all the metal, liquid metal, and these are the argon to provide some special type of clearance which will be forwarded to our molten metal to downward direction. And these are the some pitch rolls that is reducing the diameter, and the oxygen lens is used to cut the section at the required manner. So these are the complete phenomena we used for the. We can say it is used for our purpose, elimination of purpose of quality, increasing the high speed steel, or we can say the increasing the steel quality with this diagram. So on the third section, what we'll say, before the casting project started, a solid starter or dummy burmer is inserted into the bottom of the mold. Okay, this is the bottom of the mold, this is the bottom section of the mold. Okay, now what happens, the molten metal is then poured and solidified out of the state bar, which is the bar is withdrawn at the same rate with the metal is poured. So the cooling rate is such that the metal developed a solidified skill cell to support the itness and during its travel downward, and speedily, basically, typically on for 25 mm per second, it will be produced. So we can say that the shell thickness of the existing and existence of the mold is about 12 to 8 millimeter. That is, additional cooling is provided by water spray along the travel path of the solidified metal, and the mold is generally coated and with graphite or similarly solid lubrication to reduce the friction, or because of the adhesion at the molten metal interfaces, the molten are rapidly to further the reduce the friction in the stuckness. So this basically what happened, this diagram, I'll just tell you again, once again, it is simple diagram to understand that they allowed to, this is a ladle, we can collect all the liquid material from the furnace, and you allow to convert, drop down into this particular gap, which is filled up by the, this is an empty cabin, you can fill up by this molten metal, and this metal is liquidify, convert, solidify, and this solidified metal will structure a formation from in a higher, in an inner portion, starting portion. You can see the diameter or the thickness are very large, and the end of the portion, the diameter or thickness is very less, because with the help of this roller we can reduce the diameter or thickness and apply the certain forces at a particular point. So for this we reduce the diameter or thickness, and you can find this type of basic application of this to fabrication of a rail, or to fabrication of the rail track which we use for the high speed quality steel we required. So this is type of operation we perform for the industrial application for making the steel for high quality. So these are some general advantages of continuous casting. I hope you understand. Now the second term is this tire casting, because it's the most important part for making the composite material. If you want to make the composite material, you must be reminded that the tire casting is one of the most widely popular technique we use nowadays in the world. And because you can use with the help of this, you can see here, this is a starter. You can see this is a starter which is made of graphite material, and you can see this is white. This is the aluminium for aluminium covering on the surface of while during the making mixing of the reinforcing material, and for making the composite material with the increasing of the proper mixing, we require a stirrer, and with the stirrer, these are the stirrer controller for maintain the temperature, or for maintain the RPM of the stirrer as per our requirement, as per the requirement of our application. So the stirrer casting technique is the most important type of casting which we required for composite, making the composite material. And any type of composite material you will be fabricated on the stirrer casting technique. It is now very popular and really good, and we can say it is giving the good result and for making the composite material. Now you can see this diagram, the heating of composite material while doing the manufacturing composite material, that is aluminium metal matrix, you can see here. This is a white section I indicate here, this is aluminium 6063, and these are the black portion you can see here, these are the powder of silicon carbide, because if you want to increase the capability of aluminium alloy, you know that the aluminium is a lighter material, a very less conductivity, the conductivity melting point is very low. If you want to increase the property of the aluminium, you can increase the property of aluminium by mixing of addition of reinforcement material in it with the help of the centrifugal casting. This is the electric furnace, you can see here. This is the electric furnace. This is electric furnace we have to used for the making the stainless, used for the composite material. Generally, what is the application of composite material? I'm just telling you, the application of composite material is everywhere. Every automobile part are nowadays made up of for the composite material. Not a single alloy used for the fabrication purpose. You know, for example, that if you know that very well, that is aluminium is not sufficient for providing the high strength, or aluminium have not very high melting point. So what we do, if we increase the property of aluminium, So with this addition of the some 20% metal, this is your silicon carbide when I added in this diagram, you can see here. And if you want to make another type of aluminum metal composite, so you must be added the another type of alloys, which is more harder than the property of aluminum. So after mixing of the both type of two or more different type of alloys together and mixed with the furnace for the stirrer, we can say this stir casting, that is the stirrer we use for the mixing purpose, is a stirrer. This is a graphite stirrer used for the mixing these two type of mixture together and form a new composite material, that is aluminum metal composite. So this type of we can say fabricated on the some certain temp, because we know that there is a temperature of the aluminum is melted above approximation 600 to 800 degrees Celsius, and so that we require a furnace approximation 1000 to 12000 degrees Celsius sufficient for that making the aluminum metal matrix composite. If the aluminum metal matrix composite is not basically we can say that the aluminum is a very light material, and we increase the property of aluminum nowadays. Because aluminum is very easily available and very low price available of money, so we want to increase the property. And every researcher will work on that to increase the properties of aluminum. So these are the some structure I am just showing you, to the mixing of two different alloys together with the help of graphite stirrer. Now you can see here in this diagram the graphite you can see here curriculum that is used for the collecting the or mixing the proper of aluminum metal matrix. After the mixing, these are the staging initial stage where the aluminum is completely melt, and increasing the silicon carbide at a certain temperature of 729 approximately Celsius, and mixing allowed with the help of graphite. After that, you will allow to find that is a mixing of aluminum 60 with the SiCSCI, that is silicon carbide, and silicon carbide is used to basically mix with them and increase the property of alloy. We can check the mixed metal with the help of that hardness tester or any other type of a mechanical testing machine. Now stir casting basically work that is the working, how it working basically working is the furnace temperature was first raised above the liquid or temperature of aluminum near about 805 degrees Celsius to melt the alloy aluminum completely, and then was then cooled down just below the liquid up to keep the slurry in the semi solid state, and the silicon carbide reinforced aluminum metal matrix were prepared by the stir casting process. Aluminum were melted in the furnace, and then the temperature of the liquid aluminum reached the 805 degrees Celsius. Heat treated silicon carbide particles were added in the molten metal turned for the funnel at 805 degrees Celsius. When the silicon carbide particle heated at 80 degrees Celsius for about 3 hours, an electric resistance furnace is assembled with the graphite implant used as a stirrer was for the stirring purpose. We can say that after the silicon carbide, the addition the liquid metal reinforcement mixture where was stirred for the 10 minutes and the RPM of 100, automatic stirred with the help of the stir casting machine at the rate of 100 RPM. It is stirred, pre-treated silicon carbide particles were added manually to the vortex, and after the stirring process by mixing of pour into the other metal and get the desired shape of the specimen, and the presence of reinforcement through the specimen was by the cutting. That are the casting is different in location. The under microscopic examination, you can find out the microscopic examination for find out the proper mixing of aluminum and carbide in aluminum matrix or not. You can find out with the help of the electron spectro micro analysis, or you can SEM, that is scanning electron microscopic test. With the help of the, you can find out the microstructures on of the aluminum matrix composite. With the help of this, you will able to understand that how metal casting will done, and how the stirring casting will be performed for mixing two or more alloy different together and form a composite material. So these are the some working principle of the composite material, how composite material will make. These are some this layout diagram of the completely structure of electric furnace with the electric stirrer. You can see here, this is the first portion is motor, second portion is a shaft, third portion molten aluminum, thermocouple, practical injection chamber, insulated hard chamber, Fehmarn's furnace and check stick, graphite coagulable. So these all are the components of the electric arc furnace to use for making the composite material, and you will fabricate any composite material, but in the below the range of furnace, because first of all you check the type of melting point of that particular material, and after that you will set the range of furnace as per the application of you want to fabricate or you want to melt as a type of workpiece as a aluminum alloy. So basically what happened, we can say that the final product prepared by the strike casting, you can see here, after mixing or after solidify the liquid, you can see here, these are the final product I am fabricated on the strike casting technique. You can see here, these are the aluminium portion, these are the some, you can see black portion is indicated, these are the silicon carbide. These are the silicon carbide are mixed with them and properly mixing of composition are checked by the SAM and EDS checked, or the mechanical property will be checked by the UTM, that is Universal Testing Machine, Hardness Testing Machine, Impact Testing Machine, Fatigue Testing Machine. So these all are the mechanical tests will be performed on it, and you find out the comparison between the pure aluminium property and the reinforcement aluminium property, matrix property, and compare together, and you find out the result. That is, you will get the result of benefit on the aluminium metal matrix composite, because it is a mixing of the, due to the mixing of the silicon carbide, aluminium property will enhance it. Will enhance with the mixing of the silicon carbide, it will be advantageous for any material which is have a lighter material, and you increase the higher material, higher the property, it will be possible in the strike casting technique, and you will be fabricate any material like this. So basically the role of composite material is to prepare the product as a completely microstructure. This is not how we can say this is completely microstructure. We will be understand by the microstructure testing, and we will be find out there some microstructures on also. So with the help of this, you will be understand that the proper mixing of material in aluminium's aluminium portion, these are some black portion, silicon carbide portion, and if we required the machining preparation for smooth surface finishing, because these are the rough surface. This is not required for our purpose. So we required the rough remove the surface of this. Machining preparations are will be done for that particular of specific parameter, that is facing, or we can say that turning with the help of single pin into on the convection or convection machines. Now is the time to understand how much you learn from this slide or PPT or the today lecture. Some question arrives are first multiple questions of the first is, in a pressure die casting, what is the minimum pressure that can be applied? The options are 50 kg per cm², second 60 kg per cm², 76 kg per cm² or 80 kg per cm². The correct answer of the question is 70 kg per cm² is the minimum pressure we required for applied the pressure die casting. Second is, what is the maximum pressure which can be applied in pressure die casting is 4,538 kg per cm², 4,980 kg per cm², 5,000 kg per cm², or 5,100 kg per cm². The correct answer of this question is 5,000 kg per cm², the maximum pressure we adopt or you can apply in the pressure die casting. Now the third is, the alloy of which of the following metal is not used for the hot chamber die casting? The questions options are tin, lead, zinc, and iron. Tin, lead, zinc, and iron. And the correct options are questions of the answer is D. That is, iron is used for the alloy which is not used for the hot chamber die casting. Fourth is, which of the following forces to provide continuous pressure on the metal in centrifugal casting? The options are spring force, B centrifugal force, C gravitational force, and D is the frictional force. And the correct answer of this question is centrifugal force is used to provide a continuous pressure on the metal in the centrifugal casting. Fifth is, which of the following method are casting is best suitable for the casting of hollow pipe and tube? The correct options are that is the investment casting, B permanent mold casting, C die casting, and D is the centrifugal casting. And you can find out the answer that is B, D. We can say that D is the centrifugal casting is the type of casting which is best for the casting of the hollow pipe in the tubes. If you want to fabricate the hollow pipe or hollow tube, you can select the centrifugal casting. This is the most widely used and accuracy you will be provided too much because these are the advantages of the centrifugal casting. Next question is centrifugal casting. That is the options are it is used to ensure the purity and density of extremely of the casting. B is that it is used to cast symmetrically objects. C is it is used to obtain the high density and the pure casting. D is used heavy cast iron mold to act as a chill. That is the answer of the correct answer is A. That is used semi-centrifugal casting. It is used to ensure purity and density at the extremities of a casting. And seventh question is spear is the casting referred to the following options are gate, runner, riser and vertical presser. The correct answer of this D. D is the vertical presser is used to spear in running the casting is referred to for the particular vertical presses. Eighth is in slush casting process. The options are A. Molten metal is fed into the cavity in metallic mold by gravity. B. Metal is poured into the die cavity and after a predetermined time, the mold is inverted to permit a part of metal till its molten state to the flow of the cavity. C. The cavity is filled with a pre-calculated quantity of a metal and a core of plunger is inserted to force the metal into the cavity. And D. The metal is forced into the mold under the high temperature. That is the correct answer to the question is B, which is the in a slug casting process, the metal is poured into the die casting cavity and after a predetermined time, the mold is inverted to permit a part of the metal still is molten slag to flow the out of the cavity. And the second last question is in catalyzed process, what happened basically, the options are A is the molten metal is fed into the cavity and metallic mold by cavity. B, metal is poured into die cavity and after it be determined time that mold in converted to permit a part of metal steel is molten step to flow out of cavity. C, cavity is filled with the pre-calculated quantity of the metal and a core of plunger is inserted to force that is metal is cavity. And D is the metal is forced into the mold under the high pressure. The correct answer of this question is C, that is in catalytic process, what happened? The cavity is filled with a pre-calculated quantity of metal and a core or plunger is inserted to force and the metal into cavity. And the last question, multiple choice question is that the investment casting is used for the following options are shapes which are made by difficult cohesion complex pattern strand casting. B, mass production, C, shapes which are very complex and integrated and cannot be cast by any other method. And fourth is stainless steel. The correct answer of the question is C, that is investment casting used for the shape which are very complex, integrated and casted by any other method. These are the some multiple choice question to understand the better of or providing the knowledge about this type of casting, centrifugal casting or strike casting. I hope you enjoy. That is the last time providing the some textbook for the this lecture for getting understanding of the centrifugal casting and the strike casting process. You will be preferred this standard books and some standard author I'm providing here and these are some publishers standard publisher. Basically what happened I'm just telling you that if you want to make a composite material you will be selected for the strike casting process and if you made the some flywheel or just a track wheel or any cylindrical or hollow type of product you will select for the semi-centrifugal or centrifugal casting because you know that the very important type of casting both are nowadays we generally used and for fabrication purpose. So these all are the factors basically our role plays to that our basic role play of semi-centrifugal casting and true casting and we can say the pressure casting are different as per the applications. If you want to make a material regarding that we can say the cylindrical or flywheel so you will select the semi-centrifugal casting. If you select for the I section beam and for making with the help of centrifugal force, so you can set the pressure casting. If you select some gear and some special type of tool which is used for the centrifugal casting, and you made the fabricate the we can say if you fabricate the composite material, the composite material is basically used. The composite material, we can say the composite material is now generally used. I'm just all showing all the PPTs and all the diagrams for fabrication, how you can fabricate the composite material with the help of strike casting process. The other some star is used for basically the mixing of the reinforcement material into the metal matrix alloy. And with a certain temperature, you will be allowed to liquidify the aluminium and the powder of silicon carbide mixed together to form an aluminium metal matrix composite. And after that, you will check the property of pure aluminium and the aluminium metal matrix composite. And you definitely find that the aluminium metal composite will increase the property as compared to the pure aluminium. So these are some advantages of the centrifugal and strike casting. I hope you are enjoying this today lecture. Because basically based on the production case and generally the production in production industries, this all this type of a casting method we used for fabrication the product or to make a finishing good property or to enhance any property, such type of material be fabricated by the help of semi-central casting, central casting and pressure casting, or as well as for making the composite material, you select the strike casting technique. So I hope you enjoying the today lecture. If you have any doubt, any query, then you will drop drop an email with my question, that is amit.tiwari@mygyanmay.com, and contact me on my email, contact me on my number at 690-319-448. Thank you so much for patience listening. Thank you so much.